Omicron spreading rather as quickly as it is, spreading as quickly as it is. What do people need to know and do right now when it comes to vaccination?
Yeah, it does spread really fast. We see a doubling time of about 2.5 days. And that means that in about 2 weeks, would be at 50 times the actual infections that we are right now. So that's really significant. So when it comes to trying to prevent this, there are a few things. One is there seem to be data showing that a third dose is more protective. We also need to listen to all the public health measures, restrict our contact circles, mask, stay outdoors as much as possible. I know you show that weather report. In some places it's going to be really hard. and test extensively. Those are some ways we're going to try and get out of this really fast moving Omicron wave.
When it comes to third shots, let's spend some time there, because I'm hearing some questions anecdotally this morning, wondering, in terms of when you get to that third dose, what does it feel like, Dr. Cora Constantinescu? Is it the same side effects-wise in terms of effects that you will likely experience upon a third dose?
Yeah, that's right. So it seems like the side effect profile is very similar to the first two doses. So nothing new in terms of more severe or rare side effects. On the rare side effects like myocarditis, it's somewhere between the first and the second dose in terms of likelihood of getting it. So nothing new, likely more of the same: sore arm, fatigue, maybe feeling a bit tired, some headache afterwards. So similar side effect profile to the first two doses.
Now, here's a question about which kind of vaccine to get. I was one of the Canadians who got two doses of AstraZeneca, so then I got Moderna. But hearing from somebody who had one dose of AstraZeneca and then Moderna, getting set for a third dose, and hearing that where he gets his shots, they're only doing Pfizer. Is that okay to get Pfizer, or should he wait for Moderna? This is all about which to get and when. Some of these questions coming back again.
Yeah, lots of questions around this. So what we know is that a third dose with an mRNA vaccine seems to be quite protective and quite a bit better, and especially seems against this Omicron variant. So my strong push is to just get that third dose when it's available to you.
Either one, either Moderna or Pfizer.
Either one. Now there are data showing that with Moderna, so using the booster dose of Moderna, does seem to work better in people who are older, so in the elderly, and people who are immunocompromised. So using the Moderna series seems to work a bit better in that kind of population. And it seems that the half dose, so that's the booster dose with Moderna, is just as good as using a full dose of Moderna as a third dose. So it depends a bit on who you are when you're getting these vaccines. But really, we are probably splitting hairs and looking at a very small difference. So getting a third dose in is more important than trying to choose which of the two to go for.
Okay. We did hear Canada's strategy of mixing and matching ended up being a good one in terms of results down the line, as it turned out. So somebody who had two doses of one of the mRNAs originally, are they okay to get, again, the third dose of that same one, or should they bring in the other mRNA at this point?
So that's not as clear as you know, which one to use. I wouldn't, if you've had Moderna, I would not switch to a Pfizer dose just so that you can have a different vaccine. What we are recommending is preferentially having the mRNA vaccines, just because of their increased effectiveness and also better side effect profile. So, but you are right that it seems that Canada has done well both on the mixing mixing of vaccines, and also on the longer interval between the two doses.
I want to talk about interval, because we're hearing that the second dose to third dose, the interval was to be 6 months, and now, with a lot of factors coming into play, some provinces are reducing it to 5, and now even a shorter interval to 3 to get more Canadians this third dose. Does the science support that? Is that safe?
Yeah, so there's no real magic to the 6 months. It's based on vaccinology principles and also on the fact that when people looked at the first two doses of an mRNA vaccine being given 3 to 4 weeks apart, around that 6 month period is where immunity seemed to wane. So protection seemed to go down around the 6 month period, hence the 6 month recommendation. Now, this is obviously before Omicron. So now we're looking in the face of this new threat that is faster moving, where it that has some vaccine escape. So the lower intervals to the shorter intervals to that third dose are mostly based on that aspect of now saying we're dealing with a new threat, new variant that seems that we need that third dose for to fight. So that's what's playing into those decisions.
So go ahead and get it again whenever you become eligible, I'm hearing, as you say. And what about for children? Because we've had reporting this week, Dr. Constantinescu, that parents are concerned their little ones, 5 to 11, just have the one shot at this point, won't get the second shot until the new year. And the guidance for children has been an 8-week interval. And now they're using their informed consent to ask their doctors to give their children shots at 4 weeks. Again, is that okay?
Yeah, I think it makes sense. So the 8-week interval was recommended by NACI based on, again, good vaccinology principles and on the fact that if we have this prolonged interval between the first and the second dose, they had data showing that it has a higher protection and more enduring. So you just have longer protection with prolonging the interval. And in adolescents and younger adults, lower likelihood of having myocarditis. So that's what was behind the 8-week decision. Now, this was, again, before Omicron and before we knew that children in the U.S., now there are about 2 million kids who have had two doses 3 weeks apart, and I haven't heard or read or seen a significant myocarditis risk there. So that's also reassuring that now we have some real-world data. I think what it comes down to is looking at your family and thinking what category are we in? So I'll give you an example. You may have a family where the adults are fully vaccinated. They might even have had the third doses, and all the children have had at least one dose. So that family may make sense to say it's okay for us to wait 8 weeks and have that more enduring protection with the 8-week interval. But then you may have a family where some children may be vaccinated, but they may have younger children who cannot be vaccinated, who may be medically vulnerable, in whom they would want to have the older kids have two doses sooner to reduce the chance of the more vulnerable child or the younger child having Omicron or bringing COVID into the family and putting them at risk. The only thing to understand is that if you are going to do a shorter interval, then potentially those children are looking at a third dose further down the line.
It's easy to hear as you discuss with us just the extent to which Omicron is upending things as we've gone to this point in the pandemic. So interesting. And as always, Dr. Constantinescu, you make it so understandable for us. Thank you. We'll see you next time.